Hello, my name is Faris and this is Animated Anatomy. In my previous video, I have talked to you about the blood supply to certain brain areas. The brain has areas that are specific for certain functions. In my upcoming videos, I will explain these areas. I will talk about the cerebrum or the cortex. Then I will explain the limbic system and the cerebellum, as well as the brainstem. There are really interesting things here. For example, if there is a stroke in a visual association cortex of the brain, a patient knows that a car has four doors and four wheels. He knows that a car has windows and can have different colors. Then we show him the car, and he can even see the car perfectly. However, he will not be able to recognize that it is a car. You can, for example, show this patient a key. He will not be able to recognize that the object he is looking at is a key. He will grab the key in his hand and only then he will realize that he was looking at a key. This condition is called visual agnosia. Now let's explain these areas and let's explain this condition in details.
In this lesson, I will talk about the areas of the cortex. Of course, there are 52 areas according to the Broadman's map of the brain cortex. However, I don't think your teacher or professor will ask you to know all that. And we will just go through some areas of the brain that have a great functional significance, and we will not discuss all 52 areas of the Broadman's map of the cortex. Okay, we have the primary sensible cortex here on the postcentral gyrus, okay? And this cortex here is important for receiving the signal from receptors all over the body. On the medial side of the brain, you can still notice that part of the cortex here, okay? Then we have the primary motor cortex, and it's in the precentral gyrus here. And you can notice the same functional area here on the other side of the brain. The reason why this is called the postcentral and this is the precentral is because of the central sulcus here. This is the central sulcus, okay? And the gyrus here is called the postcentral and the gyrus here is called the precentral gyrus. Then right here we have the secondary motor cortex. This cortex is important for writing, playing piano, and such more complicated movements that are associated with learning through the time and while growing up. And one truly important part of that cortex is here on this ascending part of the lateral sulcus here. And this part is important for speech movements. If there is a stroke or if this part of the brain is damaged, the patient will be available to understand what is being told to him, but he won't be able to pronounce the words, to articulate words, to make sentences, and because he won't be able to coordinate his mouth movement and tongue movement. Okay, and here we have the calcarine fissure and the cortex around it. Is the primary visual cortex. It is the cortex around the calcarine fissure and it is important for receiving the signal from your eyes. However, the area that is important for perception and understanding what is seen and remembering what was seen before, it is not the primary visual cortex. It is a bit more further from the calcarine fissure, and it is marked as an area 18 by Broadman. Now if your primary cortex works fine, you will be able to receive the signal from your eyes through the optic tract and nerve. But if your secondary visual cortex doesn't work, you won't be able to understand what you see. You won't be able to understand what is in front of you until you touch it. And it's really interesting how patients with such problems are not able to recognize, for example, a mobile phone, for example, if they're looking at it. And however, if they take the phone, immediately they know what it is. Okay, so this part of the cortex is important for receiving the auditory signal. It is not important for perception of the signal, but just receiving the signal itself. Okay, and this gyrus here is called the supramarginal gyrus, and this area is important for understanding the speech. So here you receive the signal, auditory signal, and this area understands the speech. If there is a stroke in this part of the brain, or this part of the brain is damaged, the patient will be able to receive the signal in this part of the brain, but he won't be able to understand what is being told to him. Then here we have the angular gyrus, and this area is important for reading words. It's called the visual speech center. If this part is damaged, not only it affects the ability to read, but it also affects the ability to write. And both of these last two parts are usually located in the dominated part of the hemisphere, the speech recognition area and the visual speech center. They're both located usually in the dominant hemisphere of the brain. There are also areas for tertiary motor functions in sensible centers, and for very complicated processes like logic thinking, playing, being talented for something, whether it's math or I don't know. And these areas are hard to differentiate because they really depend on individuality of each person. So some person might have parts really, really developed. So for example, someone is talented for math or playing piano and so on, and in coordinating music with the speech, it's really hard to find these areas because some persons don't have them developed, some have, and so on.
Now we understand the areas that deal with speech, vision, movement, and so on. But how about the things that we cannot see but we still feel them? Emotions. Emotions have their place in our brains as well. They don't have place in our hearts, and that place in our brain is called the limbic system. To watch that video, click here. To watch my previous video, click here. If you like my videos and want to purchase my software, you can go to my website animatedanatomy.com. If you don't have money to purchase my software, then at least you can subscribe here for more new content that I release regularly. Thank you.